Hello! So this video is going to be about the comparison between my Walnut Beast and my newly made Mahogany Wenge Beast. I've gotten them both strung up with the same new strings, both at the same time, and they've both been played exactly the same amount. I have exactly the same hardware in them, and every other aspect would be wouldn't be considered part of the argument by those on the other side of the fence from myself, and that argument that I speak of is the one that is raging for some reason on the internet about whether tone would make a difference to your guitar, the tone of your guitar. The argument seems to be that because pickups are magnetic, that wood doesn't have any bearing on the sound. I would put it to these people that it has. Well, it definitely has an effect on the sound just by virtue of the fact that the strings are interacting and resonating through the wood, and therefore the resonating of the wood is coming back through the strings, cancelling out, making a unique pattern per material that is used. So it does affect the tone. Whether that's negligible to your ear or not is the question, I think. And that's subjective. You can't really find that true or false. Empirically, I find it to be true. It's not negligible. It's a pretty big difference, especially from a playing point of view. But regardless, here we go. So I've got my Walnut Beast here. The Walnut Beast. I'm just showing you across the hardware and where I know exactly that this is the same as my my Wenge and Mahogany Beast. So, from the 12th fret all the way to here is exactly the same distance on both this guitar and my Mahogany Wenge guitar. To here it's about a 32nd of an inch difference. And they're both the same scale length, so the reason I mention that is obviously just to keep things nice and clear as to the details. To make sure there's no confusion. If you hear a difference, it's in the neck pickup, you can be damn sure that it's not because they're in different places. So I'm going to be running this whole experiment through my GT8 first of all, and that'll run out not through these, or this rather, but through these instead, which go to my power amp, which is up. Oh god, get in. There we go. Which is up here. Just a straight old plain power amp. Then that'll be going into my cab. And then we'll be listening through a 57, an SM57 pointed just off axis. I say just, it's not quite 45 degrees, but it's pointing straight at the cone. And the sounds that I'm going to be using through this, my clean sound is uncoloured. There's nothing to it at all. It's pretty much a straight DI with a bit of normalisation so that it doesn't create a volume change when I change my distorted sound, and my distorted sound is quite mild. It's not low gain, but it's not high gain either. You know, it's fairly tame, just to let the sound of the guitar speak a bit more. So let's get to it, shall we? We'll be right back. Okay, so after an entire day for me of messing around A-B-ing these sounds to hear the difference, I'm surprised. I've learned something from this, which is, I guess, what I expected. But I hear a difference. It's mostly in the next pickup for some reason. But I definitely hear a difference. Since the argument is purely about the sound of the guitar, like I said, it's provable that the wood makes a difference, and that is just by virtue that it's interacting with the wood. The strings are interacting with the wood, and the sound of the strings is then being coloured by the resonating wood itself. Whether that's negligible, that's for you to say, but for me it's definitely not. And more importantly, as a player, it's very important. It's an important part of the way the instrument makes you feel and feels to you, and that in turn obviously affects what you play on the instrument and how you play on the instrument. Obviously, with performing being a very personal and emotional experience, there's got to be something said for what an instrument feels like in your hands as you're playing it. And it definitely affects my writing. When I was a little bit younger, I noticed straight away that the colour of a guitar that I was playing affected how I played and what kind of things I played, to the point where there was a guitar I picked up once. I played it for about 10 minutes and I put it down and never touched it again, really, because it didn't make me feel... It made me write things I didn't like. So I thought that was quite an interesting experience, and it's made me think very differently about the appearance of instruments ever since. Some of you might be asking why, you know, why even put my two cents into this whole argument, and the reason is because I have, well, there's two reasons, but the first one is because I have the ability at the moment. You know, I've got this opportunity where I've got two guitars that I've built. I know exactly what's in them, I know exactly how they were made, and thus, you know, what variables there actually are. And they have exactly the same electronics. They've got brand new strings on them, and short of a, I don't know, short of a lot of disposable cash, or I don't know, being sponsored by some string company, it's kind of hard to get all the factors together to do this kind of experiment without it costing you a lot of time and money. And also, these guitars are quite different. You know, Wenge and Walnut are quite different in the way that they respond, as is Mahogany. So that's one reason. The other reason is I don't like misinformation. Don't get me wrong, I believe that these people who've done the experiments and have come away with the opposite view, they're being genuine. I don't believe anybody believes something for no reason, or says something for no reason. There are different motivations, definitely, but I don't think the nefarious motivation that you would normally expect from something like a politician lying to you is what you would see in this kind of argument. I genuinely believe people are doing the experiment, but maybe not as thoroughly as would yield the best results, or they're focusing perhaps on the wrong things. They maybe got two guitars that are very similar in, like, they've got very similar materials that they resonate in a very similar way. The woods, like the woods I've got here, have two completely specific gravities. I think Walnut is somewhere in the region of 7.4, whereas Mahogany is somewhere, I think it's a lot further down. You can find that on the internet. But I have seen people do comparisons between two woods that are incredibly close in terms of their specific gravity. Also, there's a point to be made for the pickups I'm using. The detail that comes out in a broad spectrum response, such as the kind you get from the Alumitones, that's got to, you know, help your ear pick up the smallest details. And that's, I guess, part of the reason why I like them. Obviously, I've spoken about them before in other videos, or another video, but... Chris, falling over. I think if you do this comparison with pickups that are kind of lacking in the high end, you're probably gonna miss something. I think, you know, it's gonna be a lot harder for your ear to pick up the differences, and obviously that's what we're talking about when it comes to about sound. When it comes to the sound of a guitar. So I like making sure that if somebody believes something, that there's a good reason for it. And that's obviously why I did the experiment myself. I've come across too many people in my life that believe something for a reason, but that reason has no substance. You know, the kind of thing you learn when you're a child, because some big person said so, and it sticks in the back of your mind, and you base a lot of your later decisions on a piece of information you've never questioned, because when you learned it, you were maybe 4 years old, and you just went, yes, yes, sir. You know, that's unfortunately how it is, especially if you get told a piece of information to be true, and then another huge thing happens, and you completely forget about that bit of information and focus on the huge thing that just happened. You never go back, or I say you never. Some people never go back and think, why do I believe this again? Oh yeah, it's absolute bullshit. Let's discard that and start again. It's also very hard for people to do that, I think. I'm not saying I'm perfect either. I mean, I've got many things. There are things I learned when I was in primary school, which, thinking of it now, they're retarded. But for a long time, I never questioned them. I just think making sure that you go over and take stock of what is actually true that you believe is a very important part of life and learning. And some people, I think, run away from that. Anyway, too much running on philosophical things. Not that I don't enjoy it, but some of you guys might not. So I'm going to leave you to your day now. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed the comparison. I hope it was educational in some way. And I'll probably see you when I've built a base or something. Bye-bye.